Hello guys, welcome to my this video, and in this JavaScript tutorial I will discuss about REST parameter. But before that, if you don't know what is parameter and the benefit of parameter, so you can write in comment. I will make a separate video on that. And guys, first of all, you have to be know how the REST parameter came. So when the JavaScript version 6, I mean someone called it ECMAScript 6 and someone called it ES6 in a short form of ECMAScript 6. So when it was 6 version introduced, so that time we get this one REST parameter, and this is very important. Okay, so now I will start to show how to use REST parameter. So you can see here I already have opened Visual Studio Code Editor, and here is in a JS file I will write the code, and this name is custom.js. So you can write any name of this JS file, and just extension will be .js. And now here I will write the code for REST parameter. So now here if I write function, and the function name is REST param, okay. But function name, guys, I always say you can write as per your choice. So here you can write your name also, and function we can define OS. Like here we can define this using a function keyword. This is the keyword, so you have to be write function keyword, okay. Otherwise just remove this keyword and only the name, only the function name, then equals to parenthesis equals to an arrow. So you can write this way function also, and that's called arrow function, and someone called it fat arrow function, okay. So you can define this way also, but now here I will define as a function keyword, okay. And now guys, REST parameter. So if you don't know the about parameter, so you know how we pass parameter. Like here we pass parameter like this, okay. Suppose two parameter I have passed inside this method, and this called parameter. Whatever you will write here inside this functions parenthesis, so that's called parameter. You can write here your name also, like my channel name, suppose creative, okay. So creative developer. So you can here you can see we cannot write parameter using a space. So here I will write creative. So creative is the one parameter and developer is the another parameter. So these are the parameter, okay. And now guys, here I will not write creative and developer. Here I will just simply I will pass A and B. So now A and B is the parameter. And now here I will write that is console, okay. First of okay, console dot log, and inside this console dot log, just I want to add A and B. I mean parameter A plus B, okay. So I didn't pass the value of A and B, just I have written the A and B. So now how to call method? So just you have to be copy this method name and paste and the parenthesis like this way. So if you don't call this, so your function will not be executed. So that I will show. So I already saved and refresh, and I will open my developer tools, and you can say it console. So this one, so here you can see it's showing blank because I have written the function definition, but here I did not call this function. So how it will be executed? So that's why we have to call this method. If the method would be a button click, so that time we would write like button and on click and then this method name. But here this method will be called on a load, so that time just here we have to be call this method, because this method is not calling any event like click event, hover event, mouse over event. Not a event this method is calling. This method is calling only on load. So when we call any method only on load, so that time we call this method like this. So now here I have passed the parameter name. These are the parameter. So here I will pass the value of A and the value of B. This is the syntax. So suppose I want to add A is the 2 and B is the value 4. Not here actually, sorry. Here just I have to pass A value is 2 and the B value is 4. So that means it will be add 2 and 4, because here I have written that is A plus B. So A value is 2 and B value is 4. And here A is, why A's value is 4? Because you can see, first of all, I have passed A and then B. So that is, it's denoting A is 2 and B is 4. And this called argument. So if anyone asked you what is parameter and what is argument, so parameter is this one, and the value of this parameter is called argument. So now if I save and then if I refresh, so you will find here 6. So the benefit of parameter, that is here I want to add different value, so just I will call this method, and here if I change 4 and if I change here 8, so that means when this method will be called again, so that time the value of A will be 4 and the value of B will be 8. So if I save and refresh, so you can see first method is 6 and the second method it's returning 12, because 2 plus 4 6, 4 plus 8 12. This is the parameter. Okay, and now guys, what is rest parameter? So guys, here I said that is I have passed 2 parameter, and for the 2 parameter I have passed here 2 values. But guys, suppose mistakenly or the necessary, I mean it's the needed, that is you have to be at many of values, like here 6 8 10, these values you have to be at. So how it will be at? Because here I have passed only 2 parameter, but the parameter values I have passed, you can see 3 and 2, 5 values I have passed here. So A will be denotes 2 and B will be denotes 4. So rest of the values, how it will takes? So now if I save and refresh, so you will find here, so save and refresh, so here you can see it's 6, because it's only taking A is 2 and B is 4, that's why it's showing only the output is 6, because 2 plus 4 is 6. Here you can see, and the rest of the value is not taking, because I have passed 2 parameter, so it's taking first 2 values, but rest of the values it's not taking. So that time it comes rest parameter, means the rest of the value it will takes in a parameter, I mean this 6 8 10 it will takes in a rest parameter. Rest of the value will take in a rest parameter. So how to define rest parameter? Just you have to put triple dot and parameter name. So parameter name I already said, you can write any name as per your choice. So here I will write C. So that means rest of the value, A is A 2, B is 4, and the rest all of this value that will takes parameter C. So that's why it's called rest parameter, because rest parameter is taking rest of all the values, I mean all the arguments. So now if I write plus C, so here you will find the output, but the output will not be addition, because that I will show also. So now if I refresh, so here you can see 6 6 8 10, because first of all A is 2 and B is 4, so that means A plus B it's a 6, and after that rest of the value, rest of the value means from here 6 8 10. So first is output 6, after that 6 8 10, it's taking rest of the value, because guys C parameter, I mean how many value it's taking C, so that's it's not added, you can see it's coming as a comma separator 6 8 10, I mean rest of the value 6 8 10, it's coming as a comma separator, because here now I will show you why it's happening, because A it's taking 2, so here I'm writing A equals to 2, and B is taking 4, because B parameter value is denoting 4, so B is 4 now, and C, so the value parameter C value is taking, that is all of the rest value 6 8 10, and the rest parameter value when it's taking more than one value, so that time we know we cannot write more than one value, just simply we have to be passed that more than one value using a array. You can see here like this way. So rest parameter takes value, rest of the value, or you can say also argument, rest of the argument as a array. So when I have written a plus b plus c, so that means a is 2, a value is 2 here. I will just write here. So a is 2, you can see b is 4. So that means 2 plus 4 and then plus all of the value coming in array format into a rest parameter like this. So is it possible to plus 2 plus 4? It is possible. So output will be here, if I write the output, so 2 plus 4 is a 6, and then 6 plus the remaining array. So how it is possible to add, because it's a array. So that's why it's coming 6 and then rest of the value as a comma separator. You can see 6 and then it's coming 6, 8, 10 rest of the value, because it's in array. So how I can plus? So that I will show you. Okay guys, so I will remove this thing, and now just here you can see it's taking the rest parameter, it's taking rest of all the values. Okay, so that means guys, if I remove all the parameter and just if I pass only rest parameter, so that means it will take rest of all the values. So I don't need to write another parameter, just I will write only the rest parameter. Okay, so that means it will take all of the value inside this rest parameter. And one thing I want to show you, that is guys, rest parameter takes all of these values. Okay, so that means suppose if I passed here a, b and then rest parameter and then another parameter, that is f. Okay, so what's happened here, like a is 2, we know that is, b is 4, and c rest of the value, that means 6, 8, 10. So what is the value of a? Because c is taking, c is the rest parameter, so c is taking rest of the all values. So now after rest parameter, if I pass any parameter, so what will be the value of the parameter? So that means it's a error. Okay, so always we have to write rest parameter end of all the parameter like this. Here you can pass anything, here you can pass any another parameter like f. So that means it will take a is 2, b is 4 and f is 6 and rest of the value 8 and 10. So that it will takes rest parameter, I mean c, it will takes the value parameter is a c. Okay, so I hope it's a clear. Rest parameter we cannot write before, we always write rest parameter end of all the parameter. So here I hope it's a clear. So now I will remove all the parameter, just I will write only rest parameter. So that means inside this rest parameter it will takes all the values. So now that means in this c parameter it's taking all of this value as a array format this way. Okay, so now here I will show you how you can add these values. So here it's the code like for of loop. So how to write for of loop? Just for and let. If you know how to write for loop, so it will be easy to understand, because for of loop it's very easy. So let I, and it's a for of loop, so I will write of I of c. So that means what will be the value of c? So that I will store inside this I variable, and I will be looped one by one. So that means inside this c variable, here is the value 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, that I store inside this I variable, and I will be looped because here I have written for. So now if I print console dot log I, so let's see what I will get. Refresh, so you can see I'm getting all this value of rest parameter, because rest parameter value I'm storing in I, and I will be looped. So that's why one by one I'm getting all the value of rest parameter. So now I have to be add. So how I can do that? So just first of all, here, just here I will write a variable, that is total, okay? And total, first of all, I will assign it's a 0. And after that, here I will write total equals to total plus I. So how it will works, and here in the console, just I will print that is total, and that I will print outside this for loop, okay? I mean, just outside this for loop, you can see for loop is ending here. So outside this for loop, I will print this in console. So guys, how it will works this for of loop? Suppose I have, I have just stored the parameter value inside an I. So that means first of all, I will be 2. So if I write how it will work, so I is now 2, and total is 0. So total equals to total plus I. So that means total equals to, so total, so first of all total is 0, because you can see I have assigned total is 0. So total plus I means first of all I is 2. So 0 plus 2, it is 2. So now first of all it will store in a total, that is 2. After that, then again total plus I. So that means total is 2 now. So 2 plus, then I will be 4. So it's a 2 plus 4. So the total will be now 6. So it's a now 6. So total is now 6. Then total plus I, you can see total plus I. So I is now 6. So 6 plus 6, it will be 12. So now the total will be 12. So like this way, it will be looped. So now I hope it you understand how for of loop works. So save and refresh. So you can see I'm getting the addition. If you just add here 2 plus 4 6 6 12 plus 8 it's 20 plus 10 it's 30, and I'm getting the output is also 30 here. And the one thing for less of the syntax, here I have written total equals to total plus 0. So here without written like that, here we can write total plus equals to I. So that means it's the same like, it's the same like total equals to total plus I this one. So both are the same. So this is the syntax. You can write this one and you can write this one, but here the first one is less of code, so I will suggest to write like this, and it looks like more professional, okay? So I will remove this one, and save and refresh, you can see the output is same. So this one is the rest parameter. So if anyone asks you the question, what is rest parameter, so you can give the easily reply, that is rest parameter takes rest of all the arguments. So that is rest parameter. So I hope you have understand this one, and if you find this video is helpful and you understand this video, so please like this video and also subscribe my channel and press the notification bell icon to get more update.